Thank you for being with us, Mr. Nasrallah. Many times, politicians, individuals that want to aspire to a higher office, president in your case, they all are very good at identifying the problems of the country. If anybody reads the newspapers every day, you see all the problems facing Honduras, whether it's Mr. Zelaya's overthrow, whether it's energy, whether it's any number of issues. They spend most of the time framing the problem. And maybe if we're lucky, we hear their position on the problem. And if we're really lucky, we hear their proposed solutions to the problem. I want to take it even further. I want to know more than just the positions and the solutions, but the process of implementing those solutions, given that you only have, if you were elected, 4 short years to make a difference in this country, and also that you're going to be working with tremendous lack of resources. You're always going to have a lack of money. You're always going to have corruption. You're always going to have people that want you to fail. You're always going to have the extreme left and the extreme right that are going to cause you nightmares. And you've got to do things that many people in the position of presidents don't really want to do. You're going to have to travel overseas. You're going to have to attend these little receptions, boring receptions, because you have to show up. And you only have maybe 12 hours in a day to work. I know that you've said that your love, your first love, is your work. And of all the candidates that I've observed and I've questioned, you're probably the hardest working. And that's a good thing, because you're going to have to work even harder if you get elected president of Honduras. But you still have to pace yourself. You still have to get 7 or 8 hours of sleep. You have to have a relationship with your friends and your family. And so how are you going to pace yourself, given the immensity of this job that you wish to obtain, and still remain healthy, sane, positive, not get frustrated, be able to govern in a way that you're trying to build a consensus in this country, not make anybody too angry. But really the central issue, how do you govern when you have all these things working against you?
Bueno,
well,
nosotros nos estamos metiendo
we
a la
are
formación
getting
de
into
un partido
forming
que
a party which is called anti-corruption.
Fundamentalmente
basically because we think that this is the only way,
rompiendo
breaking with the
bipartisanship
parties that we have had in our country through during 100 years, they have accentuated corruption. The people who are getting involved, we're not politicians, but we are honest people. Our intention is to save the country. We are aware that in our country there are many honest people and capable, but they have not had a party in which there could be a person
de confiabilidad
that they can trust,
que quiera ser presidente,
that want to be president.
Y además de confiabilidad,
and besides
popularidad,
the trust, popularity.
En el caso mío,
in my case,
tengo la suerte,
I am lucky
de haber trabajado
to have worked
muy fuerte,
very strongly
con mucha eficiencia,
with
con
a lot
éxito,
of efficiency and success,
comprobado por las
and
personas,
that's been proved by people,
humildes,
humble people,
clase media,
middle class,
y de dinero,
and people with money that respect the way, my way of life.
Por lo tanto, esas personas,
thus, these people
apoyan,
support
mi gestión y mi forma de ser,
the way I am, and they trust me. I do not have financial problems or economical problems, and I don't have economic aspirations to get into the government. Through 20 years, I have received proposals from both parties, national and liberal party, to be a mayor, a congressman, or vice president of the country. During these 20 years, I said no. Because each time they offered me, they told me that I could make a lot of money. Once they offered me the municipality of Tegucigalpa, and they told me that if I could steal without someone not finding out, 170 million lempiras a year I could steal. I told them, I don't want that. I live really well. I do not need that. And then say, yeah, but you would have to allow that those that work with you would do that. And you go come out with your hands clean. And I have had experiences of that type. And that's why I never accepted, because I do not need to be more popular. I do not need to have more wealth to live as I live. Then that's why I found out, because of the popular cry, that it became greater as poverty has increased, insecurity has increased, and the lack of work. So people, they tell me, get in there, get in there, we will vote for you. So I accepted, or to take this cause, this flag. First, we thought that we would have an independent candidacy, but talking with people in politics, they told me no. They said that an independent politician can become president, but would not have control of Congress or the municipalities. Thus, Congress in Honduras is the one that decides most of the things. That's why it was needed to create a party.
Y por eso estamos creando el partido
anticorruption party.
Now, as you said, if you were to become president, you have to work with Congress. You have to work with the judicial system. As you see right now in the United States, you have a president who was elected very popular, Mr. Obama, 3 years ago. And he's not produced what many people thought he would produce. Part of the problem was not that he was dishonest or that he was not intelligent. He's honest, he's intelligent, he has a family, he's not involved in scandals. But he has to work with Congress, and the Congress is Republican, controlled mostly. And now, in the past election, a more extreme element of the Republican Party, the Tea Party, has come to power, and they have refused to work with Mr. Obama. So he has one more year left. He can't do anything. He can't solve problems. He can't pass legislation because Congress will not work with him. From a practical standpoint, how do you, if you were to get elected, pass legislation to help the country? How do you resolve critical issues? How do you bring the country together? How do you solve problems if people aren't willing to work with you in Congress? And maybe your party doesn't win enough congressional seats in Congress to work with you. How do you do that when people say, we're not going to work with you?
Because you won't play our game. No voy a trabajar contigo porque no juegas de acuerdo a nuestro juego. We think that we will achieve enough congressmen in Congress. I am a person whom people believe. People know that politicians lie. The only people that believe in politicians are those that receive money from politicians. In the measure that has increased the amount of people who are not happy because they have not received what they have offered. So there's many people right now who have to stay quiet. saying that they are going to vote for the National Party or the Liberal Party or for such and such congressmen, but they will really not vote for them. Even though the National Party or the Liberal Party take them to the voting polls on that day, the vote is secret, and they will vote for the anti-corruption party. We trust in that. We trust that we will have an important participation in Congress, because in Honduras, Congress is the one that elects the Supreme Court of Justice, and one of the greatest problems in Honduras is that justice is bought. The cases are decided by lawyers. So if we have in our favor the possibility of electing these authorities during the next Congress, justice in Honduras will start to be applied. But for that, we need to have a good amount of congressmen. And I am aware that if we do not reach those congressmen, we will have the problems that Obama has. But we will have these congressmen. I have a fame of being an honest person that says the truth and that anticipates what will happen next. I was able to have that in my work in sports during 35 years. People trust me. I am a person who is not lying, that has not lied to the community. And I think that this will be a fundamental factor to win the next elections, independently of the amount of problems that I can see or that I can talk about: taxes, foreign investment, corruption. I can talk about all these issues. I have them absolutely clear how we will focus the educational problem and all the other problems of health that we have, abuse. So I can tell you one by one.
I'm going to get to those. I'm not going to belabor the issue of corruption, because I think we could talk about this forever, and we'll never come to any great conclusions. So I'm interested in your views and all the other issues. But I didn't want to stop here without asking you, what is corruption? Because we know there's some things that are very obvious. Somebody steals. Okay, but there's a lot of corruption that people can't think whether it's corruption or not. I'll tell you a story that I told another person. When I was a child, my aunt took me to the office here in Honduras to get a driver's license. And I was 15 years old, and I was dressed like a norteamericano. And my aunt was dressed very nicely with her jewelry, beautiful dress, and there was a line of very humble people waiting to get their license. It was very long. And we walked in, and my aunt looked at the line, and immediately she started looking for somebody with authority. And she grabbed somebody, and she said, "My nephew needs a license. Can you help us?" And he said, and he looked at her, he said, "Come into my office. And in 10 minutes, I have my license." Is that corruption?
Yes.
Okay.
I know. See, la corrupción,
corruption in Honduras is a form of life, is a way of life. I am aware that we have to eliminate that culture, that Honduran culture of corruption. Not only eliminate the corrupt people, but eliminate the system. We have to design a system in each public office so that this will not continue to develop anymore, to eliminate what happened to you with your driver's license, and to eliminate what happens to a businessman that wants to install his business in Honduras and who has to pay in every office for a permit, and he keeps paying.